Hello, sensuals! Boy, am I glad that you're seeing me! How are you? So, I missed making videos. I've had a pretty strange time, and I've also been doing a lot of work, which is what I want to talk to you about today. How you transform and what transformation looks like in sex outside your relationship. Now, it doesn't mean you're cheating on your partner. It doesn't mean you're taking somebody on the side. No, it means you're taking personal development in sexuality, or as I call it, sexual development. So this video is inspired by some of the people that I'm working with, and I'm already halfway through in the coaching process with several clients, and I just love what I see happening with them. These are both men and women, so it's not one gender only, and it's actually half. Like, half are men, half of my clients are women. It's so balanced now. I love this. And what happens with them, not just in sessions, but I get feedback from them because they actually have this task also to give feedback every week. And it's beautiful. It's really, really beautiful. And the way things flow, I said, you know what? More people should at least know about this, should at least know that it exists. So here's the video. What does it mean to transform in sex? Well, first and foremost, you actually begin to have a conversation with your body. Yes, you're actually talking to your body, you're asking your body what it needs, what it feels like, what it wants, and it actually answers back. And that's the beauty of it. This is a lot of my clients were actually surprised that they thought that, you know, the majority of the conversations happen in their head. Well, guess what? It happens also in the body, but we're just not learned to listen, and we're not learned to ask and then wait for a response and listen for that and translate that response, because it may not look or it may not sound like your headspace talk, but the body talks. I think there was a song in the 90s, Body Talks, okay? So this is the first and, I don't know, the most surprising thing that I see in a lot of my clients is that they're having conversations with their bodies. So their bodies are alive and kicking and having fun and being in pleasure, and they're talking, they're asking for more and so on. And my clients are like, wow, I didn't know that was possible. Yes, it is. So that's the first thing. Number two is actually when you open up somatically. So that means you open up in sensations, you open up in ways of feeling pleasure, you open up in feeling something in parts of your body where you weren't aware of. And in some cases, this actually happens from the first session. It's not so frequent, but when it does, and I've had this also with one of the clients that I'm working with, has had this, felt sensations in places in the body, not necessarily sexual or erogenous zones, but just places in the body where there was no sensation in the past. And to feel that and to become aware and realize, wow, that part actually feels, and I feel that it feels. So there's a lot of joy and a lot of energy and enthusiasm and optimism in feeling that. And some of my clients are like, well, wow, I didn't know I had this. Maybe I'll try again the task or the exercise at hand just to make sure that it's actually for real and it's just not just in my head. So I'm happy to see that. And pretty much everybody who does the practices that I give them, yeah, they come back again and again and saying that yes, they had sensations, and in every time they're different, but they had sensations in places where they didn't know they had them. They weren't aware of them. So body awareness, actually, the body talks in the first benefit, and in the second one, body awareness and embodiment. you start to live, like you inhibit, you, sorry, you inhabit, you don't inhibit, you disinhibit. But anyway, you inhabit your body better, and actually you realize, wow, this place is alive. I had forgotten about it. So in some cases, this is beautiful. And again, receiving feedback like this, either in a session, in a bodywork session, or with them doing assignments at home and then writing to me and giving me this feedback, this is what got me so, I don't know, enthusiastic to share this with you. And I love this. And I think you would love it too. So I want to encourage everybody to do body work and seek somebody, whether it's me, if we live in the same place or I can travel to you, or somebody else, go do body work. Go seek somebody who will explain to you what body work is, what it can do for you, who will facilitate for you and will guide you or will be there for you while you're doing body work and you're starting to understand your body. The way it talks, what it feels, how you inhabit it, and so on. So definitely go for that. Okay, the third benefit is that they glow. That I gotta say this, they glow. So in one of the sessions that I had, one of my clients was sick, cold. And like when, you can imagine, when you have a cold, man, sometimes the last thing that you're thinking of is having sex or even, I don't know, working on something. You just want to crawl into bed and just put your cover on top of your head and that's it. I'm, you know, check out for the day or for the week. Well, in one of my sessions, I had somebody coming in and they had a cold and they didn't really feel like doing much. And I said, okay, let's see what your body feels like doing and what you feel like doing related to your sexuality and to your body while you're, you know, in this, well, low state. And the first reaction was like, I don't know, you tell me. And I said, no, this has to come from you. So check in with your body and what does your body feel like? And from that point, so they gave me an answer and we started gradually doing what they were telling me, this person. And within minutes, I kid you not, within minutes, this person went from feeling, having a cold and not really feeling like anything, like doing anything. This person went to feeling relaxed and stretching out and feeling the pleasure in stretching out and then feeling excitement in the body. And then feeling even arousal in the body and asking for more. And the second I asked, so not the second because I allowed this state for a few minutes to change and I was just looking and witnessing and it was awesome. And my client was surprised. They didn't feel this was possible. They didn't conceive how a shift could occur so fast. And at the certain point when I asked, okay, so what does your body feel like now? And how's your cold? And the answer was like, wow, I feel amazing. What cold? I forgot about it. That was like, no, it didn't go away. It was just that the focus, like it was so much, there was so much pleasure and excitement and joy in this person's body that who was thinking about the cold? Nobody. Nobody even wanted to conceive of that. So that was the beautiful part of it. And basically that's the third benefit, that you glow. When you start doing body work, like you have to be in a really, really, really lousy shape so that you don't feel anything while doing body work. And so far I haven't had somebody coming with such low states that nothing that I would do with them didn't make a difference. So everybody felt a certain amount of transformation. And some of my clients, like the ones that are very open and trusting in the process, like sometimes I don't even have to do any, like I don't have to bring any accessories or do any touch. I just guide them. I talk and guide them through their process. or ask them what they feel like, and it instinctually is guided by them, and the transformation just happens on its own. And it is a beautiful thing to see, to witness. For me, it's a beautiful reminder that, wow, body work does work. It does work for people who haven't done anything previously. So I have a lot of clients who have never done any kind of work related to their body or to their sexuality. And I'm not talking about going to aerobics, yoga, fitness, and so on. I'm talking about body work. Body work meaning using any kind of breath, sound, movement, touch, and becoming aware of how your body is responding and what shifts are happening in your body. So this is a somatic approach. So when I see the transformation and the change in state, or sometimes just the glow, let's call it the afterglow, like the post-session glow, it's like, wow, that's my number three benefit, and the number three reason why you would do body work and, or, you know, coaching or any work related to your sexuality. And yeah, I'll just stop here. There are many other benefits, but I'm focusing right now on the benefits for you. I'll give you a bonus. The fourth benefit, it has no direct link to you. It happens through you. When you have already seen benefits 1, 2, and 3, so your body talks and you're connecting, you're having a conversation with your body, you're becoming aware of what your body's feeling, and you have glow, I mean it, glow in your state, then you change, obviously, you're transformed, and it's visible. Sometimes it's goddamn visible. And people around you pick that up. And in my clients' cases, it's their partners, their lovers, their husbands or wives who feel this. They don't really understand what is going on, but they either open up to suggestions or they start asking for things. Things that they would want, not their partners, so not my clients, but things that those people want and they never had the courage to. But because the atmosphere, so the space that is created, is so light and fun, they feel more open and more willing to, oh, you know, why don't we do this? Why don't we try that? So when are you gonna give me a massage? When you're gonna, I don't know, when are we gonna do sex? I don't know where. So this is the fourth benefit. It's not directly linked to you, it just happens through you. So it's something that you see, it radiates outside, it propagates outside of you, and people start to pick it up even if they don't know what is going on. They pick it up and yeah, things happen with them also. Not as big or as dramatic as they happen with you who are doing the work, but things happen also with the people around you, especially your lovers. So yeah, I'll put under the video a link to a post that I put on my Facebook page, and it's a post that is supposed to, I don't know, shake you up a little bit and open up a few perspectives for you. Now, if you don't resonate with it, if you don't find yourself in those situations, fine. Then perfect and super and congrats for me, and keep doing whatever it is that you're doing. Now, if you find yourself very much connected to that post, then I encourage you to contact me and book a 1-hour discussion with me, and just to get a strategic perspective on your intimate life. And from there on, you can decide what you want to do. Maybe you don't want to do anything, you just have more clarity and that's it. Or you want to work either with me or with somebody who's much closer to home. So yeah, the with awareness comes choice. So I want to bring awareness to as many people as I can. So I encourage you to do that. So check the link underneath and yeah, let me know. And I'll see you in next videos, hopefully faster.